Hello, and welcome to the first of a series of videos which introduce you to the capabilities of the MQGEM product MO71. MO71 is a Windows program which makes configuring and administering IBM MQ much easier. MO71 contains many powerful features, but in this video we will just concentrate on the basics and show you how easy it is to get up and running with the product. The first step is to go to the MQGEM website and download the product. To do this, go to the MQGEM website and click on the MO71 tab and scroll down to the download link. And on the download page, click on the product download button. You have to agree to a simple license agreement to allow you to do the download, however no registration is required. So now we have the MO71 zip file downloaded in a directory. We also have an MQGEM license file. This is emailed to you when you purchase a license, or you can request a trial license by emailing support@mqgem. The first thing to do is to unzip the file. You can use any of your zip utilities to do this. And you can see how fast and compact the product is. We haven't speeded up the video here. This is really how long it takes. So let's look at what files we now have. We have an HTML directory. This contains some template HTML files for access to MO71 over a browser. Discussing browser access is beyond the scope of this introduction video, so we'll ignore these for now. We of course still have the original zip file. The next file is a command file for starting MO71. We still have our license file. The other file is a PDF file, and this is the MO71 manual and contains all the information you could possibly need on the capabilities and features of the MO71 product. I strongly recommend you read this manual when you get a moment. You may find many useful features within MO71 that you would otherwise not know. The next file is the actual MO71 program itself. You can see that it is very compact. Despite its power, the program is under 3 megabytes in size. And lastly, we have the README file, which contains very basic information about the program and its modification history. What we want to do now is run the MO71 product. There are two ways to do this. If your MQ environment is all set up, then we could just click on the MO71 program. However, if we are running in a multi-MQ installation, then we may need to set up the MQ environment before we run the MO71 program. This is where the command file comes in. Our first task is to edit this file and change the installation directory to the one we want MO71 to use. Once that is done, we can double-click on the command file. The first thing we notice is that MO71 detects that there are 4 queue managers configured on the machine. We click the import button to import the definitions to these queue managers into our MO71 configuration. We can now minimize the Explorer window. So now we have MO71 running, let's take a brief look at the menus. A file menu for making modifications to the locations, commands for issuing commands against the selected queue manager. We have a General's Actions menu, various menus concerned with the appearance of MO71, also features concerned with monitoring, and lastly a menu which shows you the currently active windows. What we want to do now though is just look at our queue manager definition. So we double click on one of the entries. MO71 now shows us a dialog containing the queue manager attributes and status. We can click on the various tabs to access the fields. We can also double-click on the other queue managers in our list, and you can see that MO71 will present a different dialog for each queue manager. This is intrinsic to the way MO71 works. The user can choose to display as many dialogs as they wish, and each window can be independently sized and positioned. The Windows menu in the main window can be used to restore a particular dialog. Now let's take a look at another type of dialog. A queue list. We can right click on a selected queue manager and select the queue list menu. On the new dialog, we press the refresh button to display the data. By default, MO71 will display the queue name, the queue type, and the queue depth. However, we can change that if we wish, Right-clicking on the dialog and selecting Alter List will present us a dialog allowing us to change the fields which are in the list. If we click on OK, the dialog is refreshed with the new fields shown. By default, when you start an object list dialog, the object fields are left blank to allow you to choose what objects you want to be shown before pressing the refresh button. However, if we like, we can select an option called Initial Refresh. You can see whether the option is selected by whether it has a check mark next to it in the menu. Now when we start the dialog, the objects in the dialog will be retrieved immediately. So far, we have been using local queue managers whose definitions were imported when we first started MO71. Let's now see how we add a new location. We're going to add a location for a queue manager called London. As well as the queue manager name, we can provide a description of the location. In this case, we're going to connect as a client. MO71 allows you to provide the full client channel definition, so in reality, you would probably want to add security features such as SSL. But for the purposes of this demonstration, we'll just type in the minimum requirements, which will be the channel name and the connection name. Once that has been entered, we can press OK on the two dialogs, and we see that we now have a new location called London in the main window. Again, the simplest way to check whether the connection is working is just to double click on the location name. We can also verify that we are running as a client to this queue manager by bringing up a channel status dialog. If we alter the fields that are shown in the list to add the application name, we can see that we have a client connected from the MO71 application. The next thing I want to demonstrate is a powerful feature of MO71 which allows you to look at data from multiple queue managers in the same dialog. Let's bring up a channel list dialog. This time we'll limit the objects that are displayed by entering the start of a channel name. Pressing refresh will show us the channel list. By selecting the multi-queue manager icon, MO71 will show us a list of all the defined locations. By selecting the queue managers we are interested in, we can easily add and remove results from all of our queue managers. Once added, the data in the list can be treated as a single list, and data can be sorted by clicking on any of the column heading. You can imagine how powerful this feature might be. You could look at the status of all of your channels, or perhaps the depth of all your queues across all your queue managers in a single dialog. Another example might be to look at your queue manager definitions. We can look at the configuration of all of our queue managers and compare their attributes. Here we can sort on the command level, allowing us to easily see which of our queue managers need upgrading. So far, we have just looked at displaying objects. Suppose we wish to make some changes to the configuration. Let's choose as our example defining a queue. The simplest way is probably to bring up a list of our current queues. We'll just show the queues like the ones we want to define. Holding down the Alt key and double clicking will show the local queue definition. Again, we can position and size this dialog to suit our display area. To define a new queue like the one we are now displaying, it is just a simple case of changing the queue name and pressing the Create button. We can see that this new queue is now shown in the queue list. The next thing I want to demonstrate is how easy it is in MO71 to browse the contents of a queue. To do that, we need some messages on a queue, and MO71 makes that easy for us too. We can right-click on a queue and select the Put Message menu. This brings up a dialog which allows us to put a message to a queue. This dialog allows quite a number of different put options for different testing purposes, but we just want to type a simple text message. We will also set the number of messages to be put to 10. You can see that MO71 confirms that the puts have worked and tells us how long it took. If we now press refresh on our queue list dialog, you can see that the depth is now reported as 10, as expected. Double-clicking on the queue definition will bring up the browser dialog. Again, pressing the refresh button will cause the dialog to retrieve the data for display. If we now double-click on one of the messages A new dialog will be shown that shows us the content of that individual message. There are many different ways we can view this message. For example, we can show the message descriptor. We can change the detail level of the fields that are shown. Normally, the message would be displayed in formatted form, and this includes messages such as dead letter queue messages, transmission queue messages, event and command messages. However, we can, if we wish, display the message in hex. We can also perform various actions on the message, for example, copy or move them to a different queue, or perhaps delete them. This concludes our brief introduction to MO71. You can see how easy it was to get up and running with the product. In future videos, we shall introduce some of the more powerful features of the product. If you have any questions or comments about this video, or the product, or would like to be sent a trial license so you can try it out for yourself, then please send an email to support@mqgem.com. Thank you for watching.